in one diagram both the graphical representation. This is net income approach, this is net operating income approach. So what you see here in net income approach, KD and KE are constant. What is changing? That is K naught, and K naught decreases as DYV increases. In net operating income approach, what happens? K naught and KD, these two are constant. What changes? KE changes. That means KE keeps on increasing as you increase DYV. So this is the graphical representation, and you can compare graphically both the methods or both the approaches like this. Okay. So I repeat, in net income approach, KE and KD are constant. KO or K naught, that is the overall cost of capital, keeps on decreasing as you increase DYV. In net operating income approach, overall cost of capital and KD are constant. That means they remain the same, but KE, that is cost of equity, keeps on increasing as you increase DYV. Okay, this is graphical comparison. Now, if you want to just compare these two methods side by side, mechanically you can solve problems like this. So first net income approach, next net operating income approach. Step one, what is step one? Step one is calculate earnings available to equity shareholders or net income. Calculate earnings available to equity shareholder or net income, right? And what is the formula for earnings available to equity shareholders or net income? This is nothing but EBIT minus interest. Because there is no tax, there is no preference dividend, so naturally EBIT minus interest or EBT will be equal to net income. Same is the case in this approach also. First step, you calculate earnings available to equity shareholders or net income. Formula, net income is equal to EBIT minus interest. This is step number one. In step number two, under net income approach, what you do? You calculate the market value of equity. What is the formula? Market value of equity, that is E, is equal to earnings available to equity shareholders or net income divided by cost of equity. In net operating income approach, in step two, you calculate the market value of the firm. That is, you calculate V. V is equal to EBIT divided by K naught. K naught is overall cost of capital. So in net income approach, in step two, we calculate market value of equity. In net operating income approach, in step two, we calculate market value of the firm. That is, we find out V. Formula for market value of equity is equal to earnings available to equity shareholders or net income divided by cost of equity. And formula for market value of firm is V is equal to EBIT divided by K naught, right? Now let us come to step three. Step three, in step three under net income approach, we calculate the market value of the firm, that is V. How do I calculate V? V is equal to E plus D. So E we have calculated in step two and D is given in the question always. So V is equal to E plus D. And in step three, under net operating income approach, what we do, we calculate market value of equity. How do I calculate market value of equity? E is equal to V minus D. E is equal to V minus D. Because V we have calculated in step two. So from V, if I deduct D, what I get is E. So in step three, under net income approach, we calculate market value of the firm, that is V. And under step three, under net operating income approach, we calculate market value of equity, right? Now let us come to step four. In step four, under net income approach, finally we calculate overall cost of capital or K naught. How do I calculate overall cost of capital? K naught is equal to EBIT divided by V. K naught is equal to EBIT divided by V. Or alternatively, you can use this formula also. K naught is equal to KE multiplied by weight of equity, which is nothing but E by V, plus KD multiplied by weight of debt, that is DYV. And in step four, under net operating income, we calculate cost of equity. Here we calculate overall cost of capital, here we calculate cost cost of equity. What is the formula for cost of equity? Cost of equity is equal to earnings available to equity shareholders or net income divided by equity. Alternatively, cost of equity can be calculated using this formula. Cost of equity is equal to K naught plus K naught minus KD multiplied by debt equity ratio. Okay. So this is in brief what we have done under both the approaches. So if you follow these steps, mechanically you can solve any problem asked on these two approaches. Now you see, you are seeing couple of formulas, but if you see this formula and this formula basically is same, yes or no? This formula and this formula is also basically same, correct? Yes or no? Can you see that? So if you remember any one formula, you can easily find out the other version of it. Okay, so these are the steps. You can follow these steps to solve a problem step by step. Now what I'll do, I will take you to the calculator that I have designed for these two approaches. Now using this calculator, it becomes a child's play. Any question that is asked to you, you just need to fit in the numbers what is available in the question. Automatically answer will be given to you. Would you like to see that? So if you want to see the calculator, just type BIO in the comment box. BIO, bring it on. BIO stands for bring it on. BIO, type BIO in the chat box. Can you see the screen? Can you see? Okay, very good. So what I'll do, I will delete everything. Okay. Now see, the whole question is solved. Step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4. Everything is solved. You just have to fit in the numbers. But there are certain restrictions. If you go through the instruction, it says sales highlighted in yellow, sales highlighted in yellow are entry fields. Enter values in this entry field subject to the following conditions. What are the conditions? EBIT must be positive and higher than the interest payment under each scenario. Your profit must be more than interest. Otherwise, there will be negative number, right? Next, KD and KE must be positive. So rate of interest and cost of equity must be positive, and KD must be lower than KE. In all the questions, we have seen that cost of debt is always lower than cost of equity. D, that is value of debt under each scenario, must be either zero or positive. So value of debt cannot be negative. Either it could be zero, that means you have no debt, or it could be positive, that is you have some debt. Okay. So now let me solve the question that I have solved earlier under net income approach using this calculator. So let me take you back to that question which I solved earlier under net income approach. So net income approach, this is the question we solved. Can you see the question? Yes or no? Can you see the question? Now suppose you have been asked this question in the exam. You have to solve this question. So what I'll do, I'll do very simple thing. I'll go to the calculator and I will just enter the numbers that are given in the question. So first number, EBIT. How much is EBIT given in the question? Is given in the question 1 lakh. So type 1 lakh. Then next, cost of equity given in the question 10%. So cost of equity KE 10%. Okay. Cost of debt given in the question 6%. So type cost of debt KD 6%. Okay. Current scenario, what is the value of debt under current scenario? Value of debt under current scenario, how much is that? What is the 5 lakh? So type here 5 lakh. Okay. What is the value of the debt when in scenario T, when debt increases? What is the value of the debt when debt increases? So when D increases, increase D is 7 lakh. This scenario is not applicable because we have been given only one case where debt increases. If debt decreases, then you can use this. Okay. Yes or no? So I have entered all the things. Now see, solution is ready. What is the final answer? Final answer is 8.33%. Final answer 8.33%. Can you see that? Yes or no? What is the final answer here? 7.81%. So you can see. What is the final answer? 7.81%. This scenario we are not considering because this is not given in the question. Okay, and each step is calculated. Operating income. Same conditions. These yellow fields are basically entry fields, right? EBT must be positive and greater than the interest payment under each scenario. KD and KO must be positive and KD must be lower than KO, right? D under each scenario either should be, either it must be zero or it must be positive, because the debt cannot be negative. Either it can be zero or it can be positive, right? Earlier, this is the question we solved, right? Under net operating income approach, yes or no? So let me just fit in the numbers in the calculator. And calculator will do rest of the things. Okay. So what is the operating income here? 1 lakh. Look, let me first delete everything so that. Otherwise, you will say that it is unfair game, right? So let me delete everything. Okay. So EBIT is 1 lakh. Good. Very good. Okay. What is KD in this question? Cost of debt. 6%. Yes. 6%. Yes. 10%. Okay. What is the debt under current scenario? Yes. So 5 lakhs. Okay. What is the debt under increased scenario? The decrease scenario is not given in the question, so you have to leave. If it is given, then you can press. What is the answer under 14%? Yes, 14%, 19.33%. Everything is ready. Now I will do one more final question. Now you have the option of doing it manually like this, or you can use the calculator. So what will you do? Should you use the calculator? Net income approach, go to this tab. So delete all those things. Play a fair game. Okay. Now, X company has a net income of 3,60,000. So EBIT is how much? How much is EBIT in this question? Let us put it 3,60,000. Okay, relax. Next. When the investment in asset is 20 lakh, I don't need that. Okay. It can raise debt at 12% rate of interest. So what is the cost of debt in this question? 12%. Very good. 12%. Okay. Next, they are saying number in requirement number one, using the net income approach and an equity capitalization rate. Equity capitalization rate is same as cost of equity capital. So equity capitalization rate is 18%. Yeah. So using net income approach and an equity capitalization rate of 18%, compute the total value of the firm and weighted average cost of capital. Total value of the firm is nothing but V, and weighted average cost of capital is nothing but K naught, overall cost of capital. Using two scenarios, when there is no debt and when there is debt of 6 lakh, right? So we'll put these numbers. No debt means current level debt is zero, and increased level debt will be 6 lakh. That's it. Yes or no? No. Okay. And increased level debt will be 6 lakh. See, answer has come 18% and 16.36%. 18% and 16.36%. So both the compute the total value under both the scenario. Total value under both the scenario 20 lakh and 22 lakh is the total value of the firm. So what is the value here? 20 lakh and 22 lakh. This is answered. And they have also asked us to calculate WACC. That is nothing but K naught. 18% and 16.36%. 18% and 16.36%. Okay. Similarly, you can calculate under net operating income approach. Under net operating income approach, they are saying the overall cost of capital That is overall capitalization rate is 15%, right? So let me just delete these numbers first and put the numbers given in the question. So EBIT is same 3,60,000. KD 12%. Overall cost of capital, how much? 15%. Okay. Current scenario debt will be zero. And increased debt will be 6. Okay. Answer is ready. 15% and 16%. 15% and 16%. Okay. 24 lakh and 18 lakh. 24 lakh and 8. 24 lakh and 18. Done. Okay. Isn't it child's play?